In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at background sounds on the iPhone, specifically with iOS 18. With background sounds, what we're able to do is play a number of sounds in the background while we're using our iPhone. And we can easily do this from the control center. To play a background sound, I just tap on background sounds here, and you're going to hear that background sound. Tap on again to turn it off. And if I want to change the background sound, I long press on it, and I can go and change that background sound. And with iOS 18, they've actually added a couple of new sounds. So that's what we're going to be looking at in this video. Now, the reason why we're going to be looking at it with iOS 18 is because Apple changed how we work with the Control Center. This is my favorite way of accessing background sounds, through the Control Center. Well, if you're using iOS 17, you have to use the hearing control. Now, if you are using iOS 17, I also have another video on background sounds with iOS 17. I have a link to that in the notes. Like I said, this video here is going to specifically focus on iOS 18. Now, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll have a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. Now, with that out of the way, let's take a look at background sounds. Now, the first thing I'm going to show you is how you can access these background sounds. It is an accessibility option. Then I'll show you how you can access it from the control center. So let's go over to my iPhone and take a look at these background sounds. First thing that we need to do is we need to open up the settings app. Like I said, this is an accessibility option. So I go to settings, and then from here, what we need to do is go over to accessibility. And under accessibility, we swipe up. What we need to do is go over to audio and visual. This is kind of buried in here. That's why it's much easier to access it through the control center, as you'll soon see. So I tap on audio and visual. And then from here, you're going to see background sound. So this is where all of the settings are. So let's go ahead and tap on it. And here are my background sounds. So to play a background sound, I just tap on the slider here. And you can hear that background sound. Tap on it again, and it turns it off. To change the sound, I just tap on sound here, and I can select what sound I want to hear. So we'll go with night. Go back. I turn it on. And now you can hear night sounds. Turn it back off. I can also set what the volume is. This is the overall volume. And if you're listening to music, or maybe you're listening to an ebook or watching a video, you can have these background sounds play while that media is playing. And you can set the volume for that separately. So you can set it to be a lot quieter while you're watching something. And then our last option here is stop sounds when locked. So what we're able to do is have the background sound stop when our iPhone is locked. So those are all the settings for it. And again, these are all located in our accessibility options. As you can see, they're a little bit buried. So how can we easily access this? Well, what we can do is we can add a control to our control center. So I'm going to swipe down here to get to my control center, and you're going to see that I have this background sounds control. This is new in iOS 18. In iOS 17 and prior, it's the hearing control. And then when you long press on the hearing control, you can get to your background sounds. Now we can just long press on this, and we can easily access our background sounds. So we have a separate control just for background sounds. So how do I go and add this to my control center? Well, what we don't want to do is we don't want to go over to the settings app. Apple changed how we add controls to the control center. In previous versions of iOS, what we did is we went to control center here, and then we were able to add our different controls right in this area here. You're going to see that there's nothing there. So where do I go and customize my control center? Well, what we need to do is we need to go back over to the control center. We edit the control center from the control center. So I'm just going to swipe down again, and I'm looking at my control center. And now what I need to do is I need to long press in this area here where there's no control, or I can tap on the plus here. Those are the two different ways to get to edit your control center. So let's go ahead and tap on the plus. We can see that the control center has changed, and I have all these different areas here where I can go and add control. Also, what you're going to see here is I have my background control here. I'm just going to remove this. I tap on the minus here to remove it. So then we're starting from scratch. All right, so now I'm looking at my control center. This is typically how it will look for you if you haven't added the background control. So I want to go and add that. I tap on the plus up here, or a long press in a blank area. And now what I need to do is I need to add a control. So I want to add that background sound control. So now I just tap on that. And you're going to see we have a number of controls here. So what I would recommend doing is going up here to search. We're just going to search for it instead of looking for it. So I just go background. And you're going to see I have background here. So I just tap on this. And we can see it added it to my control center. Now, I'm not going to get into how we can edit our control center. This isn't about the control center, but I'm going to show you one more tip. If you like to use this background control, what you can do is you can actually make it a little bit larger. You're going to see this little area here. Actually, I might just circle it there. That little arc there, what that allows you to do when you drag it is make the control a little bit larger. So if you use this a lot, you may want to make it a little bit larger. If you don't use it, you can go and drag it and make it smaller. Again, this is new in iOS 18. So now I have this added to my control center. That's basically what I have to do is just add it to our control center. I want to play a sound. I tap on that control, and you're going to hear the background sound. I want to change it. Let's go ahead and tap on it to turn it off. I long press on it, and from here I can change the volume, or what I can do is change the sound. So let's just go with dark noise. I like to use this one when I sleep. So I'm going to tap on dark noise here. And now, when I tap on this here, you're going to hear dark noise. Tap on it again to turn it off. And once it is playing, I can get out of the control center. So you can hear it playing in the background, but I am going to be using my phone here. I want to turn it off. Swipe down. Tap on it, it turns it off. So once we enable it in the control center, we can go and turn it back off. There's one other thing I want to show you. When I long press on it, you're also going to see down here towards the bottom, I can go directly to my background sound settings. So this is a shortcut to accessing those settings, which are buried in the settings app. Remember, we had to go to accessibility and audio and visual, and then background sounds. Well, now all I'd have to do is just swipe up here a little bit, so I don't tap on this little area here. We want to tap on this button here. And when I do, what it'll do is it'll take me over to my background sound settings. So that's an easy way of getting back to those background sound settings. So that is how we work with background sounds on the iPhone with iOS 18. Essentially, it really hasn't changed. It's still in our accessibility options. But what did change is we have a new control for background sounds. And the way that we edit our control center is actually done through the control center itself, not through the settings app. So now we can add just a control directly to control our background sounds directly to our control center. So that's how we work with background sounds on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you like what you see here or if you found this helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can also hit the red bell to receive notifications when I release a new video. But another thing you can do is you can check out danstutorials.com. I have over 400 videos on YouTube, but on my site, danstutorials.com, I have over 2,100 videos. So I have a lot more content on my site. You can access all of those videos for free. I believe I have most of them or all of them available for free. But if you want to support my efforts, you can also become a member of my site. When you become a member of my site, you not only get access to those videos, but I strip out the ads, so there's no more ads. You get access to my live webinars and my Ask Me Anythings. I host those on a regular basis. And in addition to that, you're helping support a small business. It's just me in a corner office in my little house where I create these videos. So if you like what you see here, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. So that's how we work with background sounds on the iPhone with iOS 18.